My name is Rhapsody and welcome back to Patch Notes. We're back in the beta branch, so we've got a bunch of patches to have a quick look at. The first of which has four pieces of content and one gameplay. We've got the added boss relics, Coffee Dripper, Empty Cage, and Fusion Hammer, as well as the added rare relic Incense Burner. And in the Nest event, this is the event where you get the Ritual Dagger, you receive the dagger for taking 6 damage rather than taking a downgrade to a card, which I sincerely appreciate. Alright, then after this, there's just bug fixes for a while and wording changes, and here's some new content as well. Endless Mode now exists in the beta branch. There are also special seeds available, including rando mods or daily mods to let you do new daily style runs. Draft activates the draft daily mod. I'm imagining I'm going to do a lot of stuff with that at some point in the future. Mega Draft will activate diverse and draft daily mods. Fade Away activates Night Terrors and Terminal. Can you beat the game before running out of HP? Praise Snecko replaces your starting relic with a Snecko Eye. You're Too Slow will activate the Time Dilation daily mod, giving all enemies slow. Starter Deck will give you Busted Crown and Binary, meaning enemies drop 0 cards, but you get an extra energy every turn. Can you win with the Starter Deck? I'm going to be interested to see how that one goes for people. There's also Inception. Start with Unceasing Top, it's a dream come true, and My True Form, you're a demon, you're a wraith, you echo, echo, echo. You start with one of each echo form. Start with one of each form card. And One Hit Wonder, can you beat the game with one maximum HP? I am definitely going to be diving into some of those in the future, but at the moment, there's an endless mode. Come on, y'all, you know I got to do some of that. All right. Let's make it an Ascension 1 Endless Mode. Oh no, hang on. There's the Endless. There we go. So the Endless Mode, winning will return you to the Exordium with the same deck. Beware, the Blight eventually consumes us all. Now the thing is, I have played Endless Mode in my own time. Just a little bit to scope it out and kind of see what's going on. So, I'm aware that I could probably build a deck that would be able to combat Endless Mode in its current state forever. So if we get to like 1.5 hours, are we both chill if I just stop there, like, and just retire the deck rather than play into eternity? Because if I have to play as long as certain runs could live, I'll never have time to upload the episode. I will just be doing this until I am a decrepit skeleton sat at my computer chair, watching a monitor that has long since burned out. Hello again, yeah. I kind of want to obtain a random rare card, just start off with a little bit of flavor.
Give it some of that flavor.
First floor's kind of garbage. Maximum of 3 elites. Bunch of rests if I want them. Bunch of question marks if I want them as well. Burning Blood is going to be pretty instrumental, so I'm not going to be trading that away. Instead, I'll probably obtain a random rare card here. Oh, feed. Nice. Very nice. Start here. Go to an early shop. Probably remove a defend. Try and turn this more aggressive, because the aggressive decks are going to be fast enough to do a lot of loops in 1.5 hours, rather than a defensive deck that sometimes is just finishing its first loop through the game in 1.5 hours. Okay, so bash feed is going to be 8, 15, 22, so that's enough to kill any of you. Either of you, rather. And then I can just hard control after this. I'm missing 6 HP, but I'm going to heal 6 HP at the end of this fight, so all is good. I want to take a clash, because I know that I'm going for 3 elites on this floor, and clashes are extraordinarily handy in the early game for that kind of thing. It's a shame. I've just seen a whirlwind. Do I take it? I do. You have to. See a whirlwind, take a whirlwind. Upgraded the clash, sure. Find some potions. We get a dex potion, strength potion, as well as a smoke pot. Definitely upgrading the whirlwind. Ooh, and got away with it. Hell yeah. Okay, so I'm doing 8 by 3, so 24 to all enemies next turn. Mm-hmm. If I sacrifice 24 damage, I can deal 18 more. And that would be by defending before I play Whirlwind. No need to do that. Ooh! Oh, right. That was actually part of the patch notes. Effects that hit all enemies in fast mode are now significantly faster. Which I kind of severely appreciate. Just in case I don't draw more than one single strike next turn. Works for me. Got my max HP in this fight. Also, like, if we're going to be looping through the game a bunch, getting max HP every single fight is going to be ridiculous for us. Blood Vial, at the start of your combat, heal for 2 HP. Good lord. We have a lot of self-healing and support right now. I love it. Not going to take the Heavy Blade yet. We don't have support for it yet. I do intend on picking up support for it, but I just don't have it yet. So I can't in good conscience take it. I had to hit the back liner there because it means that Whirlwind's going to kill. I love Rage. I think Rage is going to be a really, really valuable defensive option for us. Especially considering I intend on cutting all of those defense out of my deck. Strawberry, Racer, Max HP by 7. I mean, we're going to end up, ideally, with every relic. There is a mechanic for this game, by the way, where if you have every available relic and you've emptied the relic pool, it just starts to give you garbage. Just trash relics that do nothing to try and kind of hold you back, I guess. It's charming. It doesn't work, but it is charming. I could also take another Whirlwind there. If I had a flex, I would, but I don't have a flex yet. Okay. 53. I'll play a single Rage this turn. That's fine. I mean, it was zero energy and it defended me for 10. It's pretty good. Yeah, I screwed that up. I would have had a way to finish this with Feed if I did this correctly, but instead I'm going to be killing with the Clash. Yeah. Damn. All right, Epic T set. Whenever you enter a rest site, start the next combat with 2 extra energy, as well as an Entropic Brew. We'll drop the Smoke Bomb for that. Reaper, I found to be instrumental in keeping me around for a while, but this deck is more aggressive than the deck I was running for this last time. I still have 2 more cards that I desperately want to upgrade. I was choosing whether or not to go to a question mark or another rest. I'm really glad I chose the card that I chose. Although, do I open the fight this turn? Yeah, I do. So 12, 36. I mean, I don't need to perfect fights, right? Endless is not a thing that I need to worry about my score in. Okay. Juzu Bracelet. This is really good to get early because it guarantees me a lot more events next floor. Regular enemy combats are no longer encountered in question mark rooms, as well as a perfected strike, a sword, boomerang, and a heavy blade. Can't, in good conscience, take any of those right now. I will smith once more. Get that bash to give 3 vulnerability. This fight isn't going to kill me, so there's no reason to use a potion. I was trying to convince myself that I could use a potion and it was a legitimate thing to do here. Oh god, you've got 9x6 here. I was trying to convince myself that using a potion here would be a totally legitimate thing to do, but I'm not going to lose this fight, so it doesn't matter. Should have been strike there, by the way. Okay. That's what I was worried about, getting burns in the wrong hand. Oh well. I'm gonna keep the feed around. Call me an optimist, but I might be able to use it. Might. Mm-hmm. Take our 9 lumps this turn. Ah, well. Didn't get to feed, but that's okay. Fiendfire, Immolate, and Dark Embrace. Immolate is really powerful on the first loop through, but it's no more powerful than Whirlwind, but it doesn't scale into late game like Whirlwind does with Strength Game. So I'm not going to take any of those. Ectoplasm is a thing that you just can't take in this mode. I'll take Philosopher's Stone, because I do need the extra energy, because we have the ability to just match it with our energy expenditure, courtesy of Whirlwind. Okay. I do want to hit as many question marks as humanly possible. Which means I have to start on this path. Alright. As soon as we get Bag of Marbles, this is real gonna take off. 15. I'm tempted to not kill this turn, because I've got a 50-50 that I draw into feed and then use that for the kill. Beautiful. Ancient Potion is probably not as good as any of those in my hand right now. Okay. We'll just take the 100 gold this time rather than the regret. We don't have Duvu Doll or any, you know, other incentive to take it. So 4 by 10 by... should I start using some of my potions here? No. It's fine. Take your lumps this turn. We've still got feed in the deck. Everything's good. Perfect. Whew. There's my money back. I'm not turning this into an evolved deck. Do we upgrade enough of our cards to use? No. We're keeping our deck thin enough right now and aggressive enough that we don't need an armaments. I mean, because what's it going to upgrade? Our strikes? Our defense? Those are our lowest priority plays. Yes! Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. It's the Enchiridion. At the start of each combat, add a random power card to your hand, it goes 0 until the end of the turn. I mean, it's good if it gives me demon form. If it gives me anything else, it's okay. Yeah, it's okay. We got Metallicite. It's okay. We'll exact kill you. And I guess I'll just set up there. I should have split the damage evenly across. That's my mistake. I knew I was going to end up in that position. Oh well. At least we got our feed off. Red Mask. At the start of each combat, I pine 1 week. Oh, I could have played the Rage on that turn as well. I would have blocked for 5 more. Yeah, that's my bad. Red Mask. At the start of each combat, I pine 1 week to all enemies as well as garbage. Oh. Okay. I'm actually going to use a lot of potions here because this fight could be really bad. Not really how I wanted to handle that, but okay. Unfortunately, we basically just needed a Whirlwind in the opening turn, and we would have been fine. Unfortunately, we didn't get that. Letter Opener. Every time you play 3 skills in a single turn, deal 5 damage to all enemies. Second feed? Too much? Yes. Deck is too aggressive to currently capitalize on that. See, these are the remaining things in our deck to upgrade, right? And they're the things that we're also most incentivized to remove. I like that we're getting Inflame. It's 2 extra strength per battle. Not bad. I'm going to try and evenly damage these enemies, if you can see. All right, well, now I'm just trying to get back to feed. That'll do it. All right. Steroid potion. Yeah, there's definitely a place for a steroid potion. Ooh, thunderclap. Apply vulnerability and AoE as well as do some AoE damage. But molten egg, whenever you add an attack card to your deck, it is upgraded. Perfect. I want to get all of the eggs pretty much as early in this run as I possibly can. Because then we can take one of those new boss relics that I refuse to talk about right now. Okay. I'm trying to lower the amount of damage I take while also not wasting my feed. Easy. Oh, we're not going to be able to pull it off, are we? Yeah. Fine. Really wanted to use feed. Oh, well. Happy flower, every 3 turns gain an energy. As well as just a lot of stuff I'm not going to take. Primary reason I'm not going to take it is just because I don't need them. As I've said before, the metric that you need to look at when including a card to your deck is not, is this card good for my deck? It's, is this card better than not having this card? Is this card better than the consistency of draw I would be achieving by not taking this card? It's not always clear cut. Okay, none of those. At some point, assuming this goes long enough, we will get the dead branch, and this will have to just become a corruption run. Until then, though, it's my turf. We'll take a ritual dagger. It also immediately upgrades courtesy of the molten egg. I love it. Combustus at the end of my turn. Good. Okay, just had to make sure. Alright. Now, there was something I wanted to mention. Nope, it's completely run out of my head. Whoops. You know what? There's nothing here I want to smith more than rest. Just to give myself some safety. Because this is the champion. We've got to remind ourselves. Oh, demon form. It's a demon. The demon form. This is all good then. We've got to give up feed and ritual dagger here. Not only because it actually provides us the defense to be fully protected that turn, but also... just because. I'm passing that turn because I don't want the enemy to purge yet. The longer I can spend without making the enemy purge is the better. Good, yes. All right. Because it gives me more time to build up my strength. This is a problem though. This is a bad problem. I'm actually going to start using my regen potion here. Mm-hmm. 75 damage incoming this turn. And I am not defended. Steroid potion, bash for 27, then whirlwind, then clash will be fine. Okay. Woo! Skill potion. Add a random skill card to your hand. It goes 0 this turn. Feed and Reaper both come pre-upgraded. I still don't really want either. It's really annoying, but I need the extra energy right now. Like, that's how we win fights. Just draw and play Whirlwind, because we need the extra energy to add the extra damage to Whirlwind, because we haven't got flex in this deck. We have no flexes in the entire deck. That is insane. It actually makes me a little sick to my stomach to think about it. We need some flexes. Who's our boss at the end of this floor? It's Time Eater. I want to take another clash, but I know that it's going to start getting in my way. We'll don the red mask for 222 gold. Upgrade all cards you can no longer heal for the rest of Endless. Never. We're definitely going for Iron War. It's the only one that really makes sense for us. Demon form. Should we even transition the enemy or just wait? Like, with our deck, we should be able to transition the enemy at pretty much any point. Fine. There we go. It's okay. I don't need to fight the enemy yet. I just need to butter them up, and then... Aw, man, I was supposed to have whirlwinds this turn, and then I was going to whirlwind. It was going to be good. Oh, well. That'll work, too. Unceasing top! Whenever you have no cards in hand, draw a card. As well as just a bunch of stuff I don't really want. All right. Glowing Tesseract. So, any of these that are attacks will be upgraded. Yeah, I'm gonna go hard. I was basically just looking for the Flashes of Steel, but now that I see Panacea, starting to think differently. I think I don't want any of these except for Flash of Steel. Do I even want Flash of Steel, or do I want Panacea? Flash of Steel is some extra damage, as well as some extra block. But Panacea is protection against negative effects, naturally. But it will, in fights where there aren't negative effects, it will keep my strength buffs. Okay, I'm taking Panacea, and I'll skip the rest. Vikoria, the merchant no longer runs like cards, potions, or relics, and his prices have decreased by 20%. Beautiful. Giant head. I hate that I keep using the ritual dagger early. Oh no, I forgot that I had Unceasing Top. I literally just got it. Bugger. I'm probably going to have a fair amount of difficulty with this fight. Let's beware on that one. This is not going to be a great time. Got halfway through before the enemy started using their really, really punishingly big hits. Playing more cards is probably going to be better for us overall there. Oh, man. Don't tell me this is how I die. Not this way. Come on. Let me die some cool way. Now, clash. Damn it. Eh. Outthrew's not really the right card at that time either. I mean, we lived, but whenever you obtain a curse, raise your max HP by 6. Flex upgraded. Thank you. We're going to rest here. We just have to. If I want to be hunting elites like I am, then we need to rest like we did. As much as I want to be splitting the damage right now, I don't know if I'm going to draw Whirlwind at an inopportune time. Okay, never mind. It looks like I probably got Whirlwind and Flex in my next hand. Yeah, I'm not taking 15 damage. All this smooth stone, start each combat with +1 dex, as well as just nope, a bunch of nope. Potion belt, upon pick up, gain 2 potion slots. Oh, really good. Not necessary at all. I mean, I have Sozu, but yeah, there's thanks though. Thanks for the thought, I guess. Okay. I mean, I can just play all of those. Damn, nothing really to benefit from them in my next hand. Tori, whenever you would receive 5 or less, unblock attack damage, reduce it to 1, and then a bunch of just garbage. If you're wondering why I'm not just taking a bunch of zero-cost cards and comboing off with the Unceasing Top, the Endless Mode is going to mess with you. It'll transform some of your cards, it'll add curses to your deck. Eventually, curses are inevitable and you just have them, right? So the problem is, if you have curses in your deck and you have a bunch of zero cost cards, you draw 1 curse and all of your zero cost cards and you're not comboing off, that curse is still in your hand. So until you have a way to get rid of those kinds of cards that would usually stop your Unceasing Top draw, if there is a possibility you will pick them up, you need to avoid them. So I'm gonna go double madness there because I do not want to pick up a curse. Primary reason not wanting to pick up a curse there is because I have Clash in my deck. Okay. Good hit. We're gonna have a lot of difficulty in this fight. Call it a hunch. Unfortunately, the debuffs aren't getting me extra strength from my flex or anything like that. You know, like they're supposed to be. Good bash, good bash. All right, we may well get out of this still. Beautiful. And... that's not gonna do it. No! All right. We're not dead, but... bronze scales. The start of each combat, gain 3 thorns. Blood potion. That would be ridiculously powerful for us. Limit break is eventually quite powerful in this deck. Should take it. This first time through the boss is going to be a problem. After this is going to be a breeze. Okay. Kind of just relying on getting a whirlwind here. Come on. I mean... could have gone worse, I guess. Kind of had to finish that off, just for the sake of my HP. Take a single copy of Warcry here. And then I'm going to rest again before the boss. I am pretty much just terrified of dying to the Time Eater on my first loop through here. Flex Panacea this early. Don't mind if I do. We've also got a barricade, which is kind of garbage for us, but whatever. Sure. Gotta make sure that I try and play to 12 cards this turn. You son of a... That's the only draw that I couldn't play. Oh man, I am mad. I will be mad until the end of my days. You got me. Alright. Well, at the very least, I've also defended quite well for this turn, unexpectedly. Okay. We may still die here. Oh, gosh. So, Thunderclap and then Whirlwind. Whirlwind would be 24. So, 12 and then 24 by 5. 24 by 5 is just going to be 120, 132. I don't have enough damage to kill this turn, so I shouldn't play any cards this turn because the enemy is healing back up to half HP this turn. I don't want to waste cards that I can play the turn after. Especially considering they're super important right now for getting me some defense against this turn. Okay. We're weakened this turn, but if we can deal 40 damage, we should be fine. All right, whew. There we go. 32 minutes in and we're through our first loop. Double Tap is a particularly good card. Fiendfire is never the end of my deck though, right? Because I can just draw back courtesy of the Unceasing Top. I could easily take Fiendfire. It's like a single target. We use Fiendfire for single target and Whirlwind for non-single. That said, Double Tap is still there. Double Tap is still ridiculous. Runic Cube, whenever you lose HP, draw one card, as well as the Lizard Tail, whenever you die, heal to 50% of your max HP instead, works once, and Runic Dome. We will get the chance to take Runic Dome later in this run, and I will be taking Runic Dome later in this run. Because eventually you just have all boss relics, right? But for the moment, I'm going to take the Lizard Tail, because on the first loop through, I want to show you the intents, because the intents change significantly. So enemies deal 100% more damage. That's the Spear of Blight. We've also got the Shield of Blight, which enemies have 50% more HP. And Time Maze. Enemies have the Time Maze power. So the Time Maze power is like an anti-infinite kind of thing. It's effectively... It's not like the Time Eater's time-eating ability where it accounts over turns. It's more like Normality or Velvet Choker. It's just a 15-limit Velvet Choker. There is no way to choose to not have this. There is no way to get around it. So I have my whole deck and relic set, and we're just going again. I will be hunting as many elites as I possibly can. This is... Wow, it looks like I've actually got the same setup. This is the same map that I had from 4-1. Really? Oh, is that how that works? I didn't think that's how that worked. Anyway... We can go through this a bit. Yeah! Thank you, delectable friend bowl. It is the singing bowl. When adding cards to your deck, you may gain 2 max HP instead. We'll also take the Ornamental Fan every time we play 3 attacks in single turn. Gain 4 block. The Gremlin Horn, whenever an enemy dies, gain an energy and draw a card. Also take the Medical Kit. Status cards can now be played. Playing a status exhausted card, because this is really good to have. Ooh, Lantern. Gain energy on the first turn of each combat. Sure, don't mind if I do. Toy Ornithopter. Garbage. No. I'm instead going to remove a card. Toy Ornithopter is whenever you use a potion, heal for 3 HP. Which I imagine I don't need to lay out why I'm not going to be taking that. I will, however, also purchase a flex. anger these mushrooms. Unfortunate. Alright. Well, Whirlwind kills all of you next turn. I really need to start upgrading that Ritual Dagger by killing some enemies with it. Okay, I can do it here. Alright. Odd Mushroom. When vulnerable, take 25% more damage rather than 50%. And then we'll take none of those. Now we can just start racking up that max HP. I am real pleased. Upgrade two random cards? Sure. Double tap and Thunderclap. Hell yes. Remove another card from my deck. Or I could take Omomori and negate the next two curses you obtain. That is pretty good. There's a lot of curse-giving events on this floor that I would like to avoid. Sure. We just lost Aurichalcum there. That said, we're not going to trigger Aurichalcum often because of the Ornamental Fan. Okay. No good setup to do that turn. Well, I mean, this is all set up. Hell yes. We've got the... Yeah, double tap Whirlwind this turn. Hell yeah. I should actually double tap Bash, then Whirlwind. Put the Ritual Dagger back on top of the deck. No! Of course! I forgot. I had a Dark Embrace played. So, Exhausting card draws a card. Toxic Egg, whenever you add a skill card to your, would add a skill card to your deck, is upgraded. I could take a second Rage here. I'm not going to, but I could. Just wanted to make you aware that that was an option that I was capable of taking. Didn't take, but was capable of taking. Hey, there we go. Ritual Dagger again. None of those. Definitely Smith the Flex. Next up is Limit Break and then those madnesses. Centennial Puzzle, the first time you lose HP each combat, draw three cards. That's particularly important with the Ironclad, because you can engineer that. I'm going to lose the 33 HP rather than the 10 max HP. I've worked to get my max HP where it is. I'm keeping it there. I do really want money, so I'm going to lose a charge of Omomori in order to pick up 250 gold there. And we kill with... Come on. I've only got three more cards. Oh, come on. Don't give me all setup cards. There we go. Strike. Paper Frog. Enemies with vulnerability take 75% more damage rather than 50% more damage. That is actually really good for us. There's a lot of cards I still want to upgrade. I mean, Limit Break needs to be upgraded now because we've got those two flexes in the deck and the Panacea. So we've got... the strength a lot of the time. Speaking of, got the strength a lot of the time. I mean, I don't even need to continue the chain this turn. Although it's wild to think I could have. Okay. You're awake now? We're just short of killing you with a Ritual Dagger. Oh well. We kill you with the Letter Opener. Dreamcatcher, whenever you rest, you mount a card to your deck. Sure. None of those, though. Smith again. Upgrade one of the Madnesses. This is so the Madnesses don't choke up the Unceasing Top. Same reason I picked up the Medical Kit, and same reason I will pick up the... What is it called again? Ryan's Brain, please load the answer. That is the same reason I will pick up the Blue Candle. All right. I mean, that's a pretty good opening turn, in my opinion. Seems to have gone okay. I've only one zero cost left in there, and I don't want to play it this turn, so... Oh, never mind. Flex, double tap. Double tap the thunderclap, and then double tap the ritual dagger. Beautiful. Whee! None of those. Okay, so this is the coffee dripper. Gain energy at the start of each turn. You can no longer rest at rest sites. I don't have anything else to do at rest sites, though. Like, there's so few cards in my deck left that I really want to smith, and I'm not going to be introducing that many cards right now. So again, while I will take the coffee dripper at some point, I'm not going to take it right now. Mark of Pain. Gain energy at the start of each turn. Starts combat with two wounds in our draw pile. We can just destroy them with the medical kit, so we're fine. Okay. I do just want to go to as many events as is humanly possible, try and get my Necronomicon. Which at this point is, it is readily available, I believe is owed to me. All right, nothing there, unfortunate. Sorry, I had to quickly clear my throat there. Let's Warcry and see if we get the card I'm looking for. We got the card I was looking for. Or rather, the card for which I was looking. Okay. None of those. Not even Angers right now. I don't want another Ritual Dagger. I'll take the 99 gold. I've been having hard enough of a time working with this Ritual Dagger. Come on. I'm really glad I'm not being hexed in the first turn here. Yeah, we're actually about to be caught out by the timer. Ooh. That's rough. Double tap the ritual dagger. Upgrade it. Liquid bronze. None of those, though. Now, the apparitions actually got me through a lot of really tough times. I may well take them here. You know what? I'm going to. They're also going to immediately upgrade courtesy of the toxic eggs, so they are no longer ethereal. Sure, we'll also get Jax. Great way to increase our strength. It also deals damage to us, so it's also card draw from the Centennial Puzzle. It's worth noting. Cool. And then we can deal a hell of a lot of damage. I love it. We need another Whirlwind in this deck now. This deck definitely needs it now. Unfortunately, I can't get past those apparitions without playing them, which is a wee bit of a problem. Eh. Get me a ritual dagger. No. Not even one left in the deck. All right, we'll just murder. No need to mess around right now. Meat of the bone. If your HP is at or below 50% at the end, combat heal for 12 HP as well as a bunch of nothing. It's going to be so difficult to convince me to take anything. Are you kidding me? It is up against max HP. My assurance against death. Rough competition. Mm-hmm. Come on and whirlwind. Nope. Whirlwind. No, okay, fine. The thing I really need is like a couple coffees. Always. That is what I really need. Let's be real. A couple copies of Whirlwind, as well as a couple copies of Offering. Because I am relying pretty much at the moment on the Unceasing Top to drag my sorry ass through my deck. Whereas to have some other card draw, that is to say free card draw and card draw that refunds energy. That's why I didn't just take the Pommel Strike that was offered. Would be pretty good. Warpaint on pickup, upgrade two skills. I do not want to lose Jax. Jax is pretty good. I'll take the Relic. Ooh, sure. Tiny chest. Gain 30 gold. You're 10% more likely to find treasure in question mark rooms. Excellent. Excellent. This is always the really unfortunate thing. Okay. Specifically, picking up Limit Break before I picked up any of my great, great other options. Come on, Clash, right now. Here we go. Jax for the card draw. Ooh, hell of a lot of card draw there. There we go. That's all I needed. The one apparition. Now I can't be damaged. Okay, picking up the apparitions was a good choice. Okay, I'm going to end my turn here. Naturally, because I'm not killing this turn with just one energy left. And I wanted to have Rage in the next hand, just in case. The Boot. Whenever you would deal 4 or less unblocked attack damage, increase it to 5. Second copy of Limit Break. When it comes pre-upgraded? Okay. Okay. So we're going to be using AoE mostly to... There we go. To take these enemies down. Which resulted in me wanting to try and equalize their HP before I got to my AoE cards. I'm not going to take any of those. Do I want curses in my deck yet? I've still got Nobumori. It's fine. Oh, yes. Bag of Marbles. At the start of combat, apply one vulnerability to all enemies. That is extremely important for this deck. Definitely glad I took that risk. Although I did lose my final charge of Nobumori. Over it. Yeah, that'll do it. Yeah. Heavy Blade is now a legitimate pickup. We've enough to support it. Okay. I would like extra energy after this relic. Ah, crumbs again. Double tapping, nothing. Hey, apparition. Okay, so we've taken no damage in this fight. Hell yeah. That said, my strength isn't gaining, and I just lost both of my panacea. So, there's trouble, boss. Make the heavy blade cost 0 so we can cycle through the deck a lot better. We've still 2 flexes and a limit break and a Jax in the rest of the deck. So I don't want to draw, damn it, any of those independent one. Never mind. Holy hell. Look, we just won the lottery. That was so much strength gain. Oh, man. And we've still got 2 limit breaks in the deck as well. This is the point at which we just pick up a Reaper. Oh no, but the thing is, we wouldn't be able to keep the Reaper until the right time, of course. Okay. Block potion and a bunch of nothing. Our deck is fairly well defined at this point. Do I take a busted crown. I mean, because I mostly take the singing bowl option. But the thing is, elites dropping an additional relic is ridiculous because we fight every elite and there are a lot of elites, as you might imagine. yeah, it looks like the path is the same every single floor. I'm actually a little bit frustrated by that. The kind of... The fact that I can tell what the path is before I even get on here. Okay. One kill. Two kill, and I would have killed the third. Never mind, I did kill the third. Beautiful. We need more flexes than we have limit breaks. Nope. Nope. Secret technique. Okay. Definitely ice cream. Energy is conserved between turns. Definitely shuriken, which is every time you play three attacks in a single turn, gain one strength. Toolbox is probably not necessary. Take a defend out of our deck. Gain a master of strategy. Cost three card draw. Yeah, lose a strike. Hell yes. You kidding me? Yeah. Transform a card? Transform the defend, but I don't think I'm expecting anything good from it. Okay, we didn't get anything good from it, but that makes sense because I wasn't expecting anything good from it. Savvy? Okay, the elites definitely aren't the same because you were not the first elite I fought last time. I mean, that'll do. Smiling Mask, the merchant's card removal service now always costs 50 gold. And nope. But Bottled Lightning is actually really good. There's two things I can do here. I could put Master of Strategy here, draw four cards in my opening hand, or I could put Jax here, which means that my limit break will always be active, but Jax also hidden reads draw three cards, right? Because if it's in my opening hand, it'll be the first time I take damage, I'll draw three cards, I'll lose some HP, it'll trigger the Centennial Puzzle, I'll draw three cards. So Jax goes in our opening hand. We have so few cards left to Smith, it's insane. We also have almost all of the eggs. We are missing the frozen egg still. We did see it in the store, but we didn't really want to pick it up at that point. Flex, limit break, double tap whirlwind. Yeah. Bag of preparation at the start of each combat, draw two additional cards, hell yeah, as well as the anchor, start each combat with 10 block. This is all going extraordinarily well. Yes, we've now got the blue candle. Curse cards can now be played. Playing a curse will make you lose one HP and exhaust the card. So now we can start getting curses in the deck without really that much sadness. Heal to full HP. We're on full HP. Upgrade all cards. We have exactly one unupgraded card in our deck. So we'll be fighting a boss from floor one, if you don't mind. Let's secret technique a limit break. As much as I just want to open up with a bunch of damage here, I know that I need to play two apparitions to guarantee that I'm fine next turn. I'm also not getting back through this deck, so I may as well just play all of these heavier attacks. All right, and we get a turnip for our troubles. You can no longer become frail, perfect. Oh, that's really unfortunate. Duvu Doll and Runic Dodecahedron are actually extremely important in this deck. We will take a Whirlwind, a second copy, as well as a card removal on an unupgraded strike. We'll find those Duvu Dolls, hopefully, eventually. Like, we saw something, we saw the bag of marbles in an early shop, and now we have it, right? So, apparently, my previous understanding of how the game locks items that you've seen was not entirely factual. This is a very wimpy way of saying was full of absolute crap. 82 damage on this turn. Good thing we have apparitions, eh? Alright. Because of the boot, we're actually overriding the vulnerability and we're dealing 5 damage. It's quite handy. Let's take a also strategy out of there, because I just want to get this. Oh, wow. As far through this deck as is humanly possible. Mm-hmm. And give me the heavy blade. Guess the whirlwind will do. But face turn, whenever you play a power, heal for 2 HP, as well as the magic flower, healing is 50% more effective during combat. So that means we're healing at the end of combat for 9 HP, at the start of combat for 3 HP. Every single time we play a power, we're healing for 3 HP, courtesy of the bird of face turn. And every time we're below half HP, we're going to heal for 18 HP. Is there anything else I'm missing? Every time we use feed, we're going to get extra HP. It's just lovely all over. Well, guess I'm just resting to get max HP now. Hopefully the next loop isn't the exact same. Because when I was playing before, the loops didn't seem to always be the same, but they are right now, and it's actually worrying me a little. Double up the ritual dagger there just to upgrade it. Don't need any of those. Rest again. Probably don't need any of these. Second heavy blade couldn't hurt. Whew. All right. Let's go, Time Eater. I'm ready. You feeling jazzed about this? You feeling... Nope. Any of you familiar with my brother and me will know the reference I was about to make and then decided better against it. It would usually begin with y'all particularly interested in this one. All right. Garbage. Come on. There we go. You're below half HP now. Perfect. So that means this turn you're trying to purge, but if I could deal enough damage this turn, I may well be able to. Hang on. Yep, that'll do it. Swift potion, wish I could take it. Probably not a third in limit break, let's be real. Now we definitely want the cursed key. Gain energy at the start of each turn whenever you open a non-boss chest, obtain a curse. Some extra energy for us. Let's keep going. Okay, so this effect is Scatterbrain. Upon pickup, obtain 10 random cards. This is a negative in the game. This is why I don't like obtaining like a bunch of random cards or like transforming cards or things like that. Because like it's considered a negative for a reason. It's weighing down my deck. So we're going to look to actively remove those. Yeah, it looks like the map layout is the same every single time. Oh, that's... that's a little bit disappointing. I feel like it wasn't this just a moment ago, though. If I could get like a... oh, God. Oh, I just thought of the best thing. If I could get another bottled lightning, I know you can't, but if I could, I would put a secret weapon in my deck so that then I can just draw out the exact thing that I need for that fight. Oh, that'd be perfect. Oh, well. Sure, I'll take another flex. Okay. So we definitely need to take a card removal. And I also want the pen nib. Every 10th attack you play deals double damage. That's really unfortunate that I'm missing out on Vajra right now. Let's take a bunch of the stuff that does nothing out of our deck. Okay, whetstone upon pickup, upgrade to random attack. Sure. It's time to spin the wheel. Hey, card removal, beautiful. Now I am well aware that I have a curse in my deck and I am going to actively choose to remove something else instead. Now the reasoning behind this is because I can burn the curse and then the curse won't impede my draw. Whereas the cards that have a cost associated with them, I can't. I have blue candles, so these curses are just thin space. And I also have the unceasing top as a ridiculous amount of energy. So they mean nothing to me at this point. So I'll take a relic as well as a curse. Ah, we got the toolbox. At the start of each combat, add a random colors card to your hand. I'm actually not particularly enthused to see that. I can do a lot of setup on this turn, but I could probably also just kill this turn. And I think that might be the better option. Art of War, if you don't play any attack during your turn, gain an extra energy next turn as well as Aura Calcum if you end your turn without block, gain 6 block. Perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. As you can see, all of the relics are getting tiny, and in a moment after this, you will see something even a bit wilder than that. I'll tell you as soon as it comes up, don't worry, you won't miss it. Not on my watch. None of those needed. I really need to find a shovel so I can start doing things at these rest sites rather than just gaining 2 max HP. Mercury Hourglass, at the start of your turn, deal 3 damage to all enemies. Locked. Requires upgradable cards. I love it. Oh, man. This is perfect. All right. Corruption. Panache. That's Jax and Panacea. And, oh, man. We're just going to combo off until the end of time. This is perfect. Then flex. And then we'll do that before we limit break later. Madness, one of the heavy blades. I mean, none of this is necessary. I could just kill. But still, it was fun, right? Champion's Belt. Whenever you apply vulnerability, also apply 1 weak. That also means that at the start of each fight, our enemy is getting 2 stacks of weak. One from the red mask. I can't actually see. The red mask's over here. And one from Champion Belt, giving it to them by way of the bag of marbles. It's you again, eh? By the way, I had the same boss 2 times in a row here, and that's because the last one was an event. 2 elite spaces in a row can't give you the same enemy, is my understanding of that. Just in case you were wondering about why the game did something that I have previously said it could not do. Yeah, that'll do. Frozen Egg, whenever you add a power card to your deck, it is upgraded, as well as the Mummified Hand. Whenever you play a power, a random card in your hand costs 0 for the rest of the turn. So now we have the Frozen Egg, as well as the Toxic Egg and the Molten Egg. So any card added to our deck is going to be upgraded. There's an offering. Beautiful, finally. I am really pleased to see you. Ooh, what am I going to get here? Because this gives you a relic for completing it, but we have all of the... we have the relic that this gives you. Oh, it gave us Odd Mushroom again. I wonder if they stack. When vulnerable, take 25% damage more than 50%. More damage rather than 50% more damage. Okay, so it can't stack, right? Because the way it's written is that it changes it to a certain value rather than changing it down by a certain value. Okay. Then double tap the whirlwind. Didn't even need the double tap. Pantograph. At the start of boss combat, heal for 25 HP, as well as a question card on future card reward screens. You have 1 additional card from which to choose. There's another offering. Another whirlwind. Yes. All right. I'm fine to thicken up the deck right now because I need to increase that consistency. And I need to be more resilient to the effect of things like Scatterbrain. I'm purposefully exhausting cards from my hand just to lower. The something, something, something words that my brain definitely remembers. Put that back on top. To lower the amount of cards I have in hand so that I can draw effectively. There we go. Double tap the thunderclap for the kill. Easy. All right. No, none of those. Now I could probably take Coffee Dripper. Astrolabe would be a garbage idea. Black Blood will keep me alive. The thing is, my maximum HP is not high enough yet that I feel okay taking the Coffee Dripper. And I also don't really need the extra energy right now. Maybe on the next loop. Also, if I can get Necronomicon, I will be really pleased. Unfortunately, I have... Apotheosis does nothing. I mean, it would affect this demon form, I guess. Okay, come on. Actually, just looking for exactly one card. Give me... There we go. Whirlwind. Blood potion, as well as just a bunch of nothing. Should I offer one of my curses now? I mean, if I offer a golden card, I get 10 max HP, and max HP is max HP. And max HP is good. No, I should just get a card out of my deck. Thin our deck a little more. Oh, this is perfect. This should just... You know what? I'm not even going to bother counting. Yep. I don't even need to do that optimally. I knew that was going to be lethal. Pear, sure. Raise your max HP by 10, if you're wondering what the pear is. Bottle Flame. Whirlwind. Matroska. The next two chests you open contain two relics. Sure. That's our second chance at the Runic Dodecahedron. It's gone as well. Not too pleased about that. Eventually, we'll get the Duvu doll, and then me having all of these curses in my deck will make sense. Up until then, yeah, I'm gonna look a little mad for a while. And that's okay. Let's be real, how off base is it? That works. Red Skull, when your HP is at or below 50%, you have additional strength. That's 3 additional strength. And also, Prayer Wheel, normal enemies drop an additional card ward. Now we can use that to parlay extra max HP out of the Singing Bowl. Smoke Bomb, another thing I can't have. Really need something to do with these rest sites. Yeah, look, it's corruption. Wee. Limit break, and then... Oh, that's fine. Yeah, that'll kill. Wee, nothing and nothing. It is going to be extremely difficult to convince me to take a card at this point. Any card. Oh, look, it's the Dead Branch. Whenever you exhaust a card, add a random card to your hand. Now we need a corruption. Because... Of course, we're gonna do this. Why would we not? Incense Burner. Every 5 turns, gain 1 intangible. I'm gonna take the curse. Out of all of those options, I'm gonna take the curse. Because I don't think we need any of the rest of them. I don't think any of them are really offering anything to us right now. So flex, secret technique to get limit break. Limit break. And we'll quickly just double tap the kill. Girya, you can now gain strength at rest sites. Finally, I have something to do at my rest sites, as well as 300 gold from the old coin. I would take another offering, but if I play too many offerings in a single fight, I'm actually going to start losing HP each fight. And I do have to worry about that a little bit. Oh god, our relics are so small right now. I can barely see them.
This is perfect.
Nope. Nope. I mean... Yeah, sure. They're already gonna come upgraded as well. And it's only adding two cards to my deck as well. And we have the magic flower. So since they come pre-upgraded... One sec. Gotta do some quick calc there. Since they come pre-upgraded, the bites, they heal 3 HP. But since we have the magic flower and the magic flower rounds its effect up, the magic flower, all sources of healing heal you 50% more. Every bite just heals us for 5 HP. It's pretty insane. Yes, I know we could take Rupture and then exhaust our curses for extra strength. But is that really a faster strength generation? Waiting for Rupture, playing Rupture, then playing out our curses. Is that really a faster strength generation than just having a bunch of flexes, jaxes, and the other thing that I can't remember at the moment? Limit breaks? Because I don't think it is. In fact, I would contend I don't really think there's an argument to be made. Okay. There we go. Wanted to try and get maximum damage out there, as well as protecting myself for the next turn. I mean, I can bloodlet for a ridiculous amount right now. No need to, though. Okay. I'm gonna end my turn there so that the Ghostly Armor Exhausting gives me an extra card in my next hand, just in case it was something useful. Give me a limit break, and then I'll try and draw the other one naturally. Didn't work out, that's okay. 7 by 9, 7 by 9 is 63. 63 by 10 is, okay. 63 by 10 is, that's embarrassing. All right, Runic Pyramid, at the end of your turn, you no longer discard your hand, as well as the White Beast Statue, which does nothing for us because we can't pick up potions, as well as Calling Bell, obtain 3 curses and 3 relics. We'll go for that. Sure. And we get Calipers, which is, at the start of your turn, lose 15 block rather than all of your block. Charon's Ashes, whenever you exhaust a card, deal 3 damage to all enemies. And Sundial, every 3 times you shuffle your deck, gain 2 energy. Okay, so by this point, last time I played, the portraits for the items started to invert. So instead of becoming smaller, they started becoming larger, but upside down. It was really fun. But here it looks like they will just continue to get smaller and smaller and smaller. Don't worry if you can't see them, by the way. I can't either. So we're even in that faction, in that facet, I believe is what I was trying to say there. Okay. I mean, I could start taking Mind Blasts and they would be just a lot of damage in my opening hand. Sure. I mean, Dramatic Entrance isn't a lot of damage yet, but it will be at some point. Not too keen on those, though. Okay. We want more madnesses in my deck? Not really. Take Curse Writhe. I definitely don't want 2 normality in my deck because I could draw into those and then those will end my turn. So normality is a curse that I actually still do want to avoid. I'm tempted. You know what? I'm gonna Whirlwind, then Offering. Oh, still gotta flex Limit Break. But now I don't have the ability to use the Fiend Fire. No, I messed up. I messed that up big time. I was looking to play the Fiend Fire afterwards. Oh well, still got him. Gambling Chip. Oh, that's actually really important. At the start of each combat, discard as many cards as you'd like and then draw that many. Dooboo Doll, there we go. Finally, for each Cursing Dread X, start each combat with an additional 1 strength, and we're starting with an additional 11 now. And Ginger, you can no longer become weakened. So now, our fight openings are going to look a lot like... Hang on. This. Mango, upon pick up, yeah. Raise your max HP by 14, as well as the Thread Needle upon the start of each combat. Gain 5 plated armor. Another Whirlwind. Actually, I don't think I need more than Whirlwinds right now. It's my bad. Oh, they are starting to invert and get larger. Oh, we just you wait. You are in for a treat. So my whole goal here is going to be set everything up for a giant mind blast. Never mind. All right, we've officially started to reach the end of the pool of relics. So these are placeholder relics that do nothing. Circlet looks pretty. It looks pretty. So we just get two of those. I'll take them, regardless. Oh, another circlet. It looks pretty. Don the Red Mask for 222 gold. If I could find a store, that'd be handy. Another circuit. Circlet, rather. Sorry. I wonder how it looks. Okay, so something that's going to be useful for me, just so I can open fights, is... I'm just going to confirm to keep all of that. Is Whirlwind comes with 23 damage. With the vulnerability we apply to the enemy, so it's 75%. So let's just say it does 16, right? It should be around 16 more damage. So it's 39. It's one short of 40, so let's round up. 40 by 8. 40 by 8 is mass, as it turns out. 320. So we've got far more than lethal right here. Oh, and it is 40, actually. Awesome. Take a whole bunch of nothing there. That's our final lift with Gearia. So what relics are we still missing? That's actually a really good question to ask ourselves. What relics are we still missing? Shovel. A lot of the shop relics, like Toy Ornithopter, still missing. As well as Frozen Eye, Strange Spoon. Is that it? May well be. Okay. So now, unfortunately here, I do know that I don't have enough to kill the Awakened One without doing some extra stuff. So we'll double tap Whirlwind. Oh. I was all ready to do more stuff. Oh well. I was gonna double tap the Whirlwind and then I was gonna double tap the other attack as well. You know, the other attack. Who needs to clarify when you're as specific as this? Oh, kill with a giant feed. I wish I could. It's got to be a bludgeon, though. Thump. And the whole machine starts up again. Fusion Hammer. Gain energy at the start of each turn. You can no longer smith at rest sites. That's fine though, right? Because we have all three eggs, so it is impossible for us to have a card introduced to our deck that is not already upgraded. So we'll take the Fusion Hammer there. Impressive. More. And now it's just transformed five cards in my deck. So unfortunately, it doesn't tell you what five cards it's transformed, but I should be able to get a reasonable idea if it's taken anything particularly important from me. It hasn't taken my Double Tap. It can't take my Jax, and it can't take my Whirlwind, which is, those are the two kind of things that I'm really using for engine at the moment. So unfortunately, like, if I could change what was in the Jax, I would now change it to a Limit Break, but unfortunately I don't get that opportunity. Okay. So it can't have changed any curses. Well, it looks like I lost one Apparition. And then the rest are so unimportant as to not be noticeable. Okay. The unfortunate thing is I have to wait so long before I can hit the confirm button before I start my fight. Really wish I could also collect those cards a lot faster somehow. Okay, we'll take the shovel, we'll take the kunai, we'll definitely take the runic dodecahedron, we'll take the self-forming clay, and we'll take the regal pillow. And that is literally just so that I can pick up the rest of the relics, really. Another golden idol? Sure, I'll take 50 damage in order to take it. Hey, Vajra, studies combat with plus one strength. Hell yeah. As well as there, we also picked up a... While we were picking up Vajra, we also picked up another curse, which is another strength for us in the opening of the fight. I mean, can you see why it's not going to be possible to stop me? I don't, like, I've played for a couple hours in a row before. And I just kept getting things like Scatterbrained and Twisted Mind. I also got one which was adding two curse cards to your deck. But with my Duvu Doll and the fact that I can exhaust curse cards and the fact that I have infinite energy and the fact that I have infinite draw, it's not... there's the Frozen Eye. It's not possible to give me a curse card that isn't... Well, I mean, okay, never mind. There is exactly one curse card you can give me that is bad. And it is the exact one you would think it would be. One sec while I wait for the confirmation. Beautiful. It's the exact one you would think it would be, Normality. So if you get a Normality, you need to remove that from your deck. That's about it. Other than that, we just go. We're an Energizer Bunny. Nothing can stop us. We're having such a good time. We're having a ball. Come on, and just, give me control of the turn back. So I don't know if there's much after this point. I feel like duty bound to check. Because I'm gearing up to wind down this episode at the end of this run. Because again, it's endless and this deck won't die. I've had like 500 floors before with this same kind of deck with the Ironclad and it just doesn't die. You can see why. Also, like if I was ever starting to feel like, oh, I'm in a little bit of danger here. Definitely not Snek, am I? We'll take the Busted Crown, sure. Gain energy, but have two fewer cards from which to choose. That's fine. I don't really need them. Give me Necronomicon, though. That's one thing I do want to turn up in this game. But the thing is, if I ever felt like, oh, I now have the capability of losing HP, which we don't really, then all I need to do... Definitely not taking a bunch more apparitions. Then all I need to do at that point is add a Reaper to the deck. That's it, and we win. Now, I suspect with other characters, it will be more difficult to maintain a perfect because the other characters have less healing potential. Circlet looks pretty. So keeping yourself alive and generating a ridiculous amount of energy to do these kinds of things reliably at the start of each fight is not something that comes easily to either of the other classes. Like, it comes much more naturally to the Ironclad. So I don't know how the other classes are going to do in this mode. Also, this is the first episode since I designed them, but a long while ago when I was when I stopped doing defect videos but still had the defects update thumbnail, there was a lot of feedback saying, hey Rhapsody, you know, the thumbnail's kind of misleading, it'd be nice. Ooh, I can trade the mango, that's actually fine. Nice. The thumbnail's kind of misleading, it'd be nice if the thumbnail matched the character played that episode. And my contest to that was that the defect was in the thumbnail because the defect represented the most recent significant update to the game. I still stand by that, but I also do like the idea of rotating the thumbnail based on the character played in the individual episode. And while I wasn't able to do it for a while because the defect didn't have any official character art, like they had the in-game character art, but they didn't have their like splash screen. While I wasn't able to do it for a while, I now am, because the defect has their character splash screen. I could just take so much money. Give me all of the money. There we go, we have 79 HP left. We're gonna win every fight turn one, it doesn't matter anyway. What I just did is got mad rich, yo. At the end of that fight, I healed by a ridiculous amount as well. Like, nothing can stop us. 750? Oh man, that's gonna be a real rough time. You might last two turns. I'm gonna Jax Flex Limit Break before I murder you. And then heal back to full. Because I can. Runic Pyramid, at the end of your turn, you no longer discard your hand. Transform all strikes and defense, of which we have none, or Tiny House. Upon pickup, obtain one potion, gain 30 gold, raise your max HP by 5, obtain one card, and upgrade a random card. Yeah, upgrade my Searing Blow. It's the only card left in our deck that can be upgraded. But yes, the thumbnails now rotate based on character, so if you have any particular feedback about that, I'd love to hear it. I personally really like the Ironclad one, but I also really, really like the Defect one, but haven't had an opportunity to show it off yet because obviously this episode doesn't feature the Defect now, does it? Okay. Yeah, at the end of this run, I'm gonna stop because it's clearly not doing anything different at this point. I'm not even making the optimal choices anymore. Like, sure, I should be taking those Flashes of Steel. And sure, I shouldn't be opening any of these lefts because they might have a normality in them and stuff like that. But, like, look at the state of the board right now. Does it look like it matter? Not really. So the time it would take to make the correct decisions in each of these venues, it's not worth it. It's just not worth it. It doesn't pay off in any way. Just fight another boss from Act 1. Let's go. All right. Now Crumbs. How am I going to get through this one? What if I do that? then actually I could... Here's a fun trick for gaining a bunch of strength. Play cards while pain is in your hand. If you have a rupture active, obviously. Oh, and then just, you know, like whirlwind to finish off the boss or whatever. I don't want to lose... Oh, actually, I have 2 golden idols right now, right? Yeah, I can lose one. If I get to a store, I'm just going to be able to buy everything. If there was an option, the store no longer runs out of the ability to remove cards from your deck, we would just sit there and remove almost every card from this deck. It'd be lovely. Oh, it'd be a grand old time. Okay. Get him! Got him! And bypass all of that, and then dig for another circlet. I'm only taking the circlets rather than resting and upgrading my max HP, by the way, because it's making all of the relics invert, and it looks cool as hell, and I love it. It looks boss, baby. Alright. So I'm gonna throw all of those. That's a double tap. We've been through this one before, I feel. We double tap, and then we whirlwind. Oh, it didn't even get to the second one. Alright, I'm gonna double play Apparition just in case. I could play the Inflame. I could have also played the Doubt there. None of it matters. You gotta know, none of this matters. What am I doing here? Limit breaking, sure. Like, we're at the point that I could kill with just, like, sure, I'll just punch you in the face twice, just die. Here we go. Sword Boomerang. Coffee Dripper. Gain energy at the start of each turn. You can no longer rest at rest sites. Sure. Yeah, this one's adding 2 curses to my deck, which is just giving me a bunch of max HP. All right. You know what? I feel duty bound to check what exists in the infinite mode. Slay the Spire Endless mode. Because if there's stuff that we haven't seen, then I will continue until that. But otherwise, I just... There's not much more to do right now. I love that I search Endless mode and most of it is just constantly telling me about the want for endless mode to be in the game. Okay. Show me endless. No. Yeah, it doesn't appear that you can end endless. This is where it ends, brothers. Whoa, that's a lot. Yeah, no, there's no other modifiers. It is just add 10 random cards to your deck, add 2 curses to your deck, or transform 5 cards. And our deck is super resilient against all of these. Well, I don't know how much Endless I'm going to play on the channel because it's super anticlimactic and like... Obviously, I can't continue it for like 8 hours until a bug or something end up killing me. But we've reached the hour and 30 that I said, and we have looped the game once, twice, 3, 4 times. So this is our 5th time through the game. Think we're gonna leave it here. So hit that button. And then begrudgingly, this one. I can't do it forever, my friends! Anticlimactic ending, sure, but we just finished our fourth loop through the game and kind of proved that this is not dying anytime soon.
Look at that score, though.
10,000! Oh boy, it's good. I like it a hell of a lot. For the moment, my name has been Rhapsody. The name of the game has been Slay the Spire. This in particular has been a preview of Endless Mode that currently exists in the beta branch of the game. Hopefully you've been enjoying yourselves. There is a playlist in the description down below with all of my content on this game, past, present, and future, as well as another playlist down there for the recently begun modded series, which has a look through some of the mods that currently exist for Slay the Spire, even before its official release. Oh, those modders are dedicated. Hopefully you've been enjoying yourselves, and hopefully we'll see you next time.